Please welcome to Up Close the wonderful Georgia Toffolo. She is with us today. Hi, Georgia.
Hi, Donny. I'm thrilled to be here.
Excellent. Or Toff, as everybody knows you. It's weird calling you Georgia, actually.
You sound like my mum.
Well, do I? I'm telling you off. Georgia, you're here. You've written a book. Is it rude?
It's a little bit saucy.
thank you for joining us today, Georgia. So you have written your second novel, Meet Me in Hawaii, which is out this month. Are you one of those people that at the start of lockdown, you're like, I'm going to get this book written, and you're a wonderful human and you've actually managed to do it. You've gone through with it.
It's true. Meet Me in Hawaii was finished in the first lockdown. I mean, what a wonderful, all the stars aligned for me with everything being shut and like being chained to the house. I mean, the book is so much better than if Boris kept everything open.
Yeah, amazing that you got a chance to do that. It's just something that people wouldn't have got done in the real world. Is there anything else that you took on during the lockdown and managed to get done?
Oh, nothing else. No, I keep on trying to learn how to cook. I can't cook. All I can make are boiled eggs. It's just been, you know, when you look on Instagram and you think everyone's being so wonderfully productive and they've got so many hobbies and they're planting things. But I did get a dog, actually. That's quite a big thing. And he's very well behaved and quite sweet. So I suppose that's something to be very proud of. But apart from that, books and the dog.
Yeah, I mean, my plants are all dead. I was real like plant mother last year. And then I look at them now and I'm like, I'm so sorry.
Thank God I didn't even bother.
But you did manage to get your book done. It's called Meet Me in Hawaii. It's your second novel. Tell us all about it. How did it start? Where did the idea come from?
Gosh, a really long time ago. So I've always just written for, well, it's been a quite private thing. And I'm a bit of a busy bee and I rush around doing a billion things at once. And since I was really young, writing has just been my respite. And it's always been, as I said, very private. And there was a slight opportunity for me to write something to do with fiction. And for me, it always had to be romance because that's what I truly love. And it's, I think when you venture into the world of fiction, you've got to write in the genre that the words flow easily. Like the biggest fear for me is just having a proper writer's block. Like I didn't know how I would navigate around it. Now with my books, they're just full of the most wonderful love stories and female friendship. And they're just, obviously I'm really biased, but I think they're really special. And I think the timing of them, when my first came out last October, which was Meet Me in London, obviously based in the UK. And now with Meet Me in Hawaii coming out, it's proper armchair travel. And for all of us who are really, really missing the ability to go abroad. And maybe, you know, people haven't met a new love romance or are dying to meet the one, or we're all dreaming of maybe a bit of fairy tale because we're not living that at the moment.
No.
Hawaii is just the perfect remedy for that.
Yeah, lockdown dating has been hard. My friend became single just before it, and you know, getting on apps and stuff like that, normally able to meet people, it's been hard. So books like this are amazing because it can take you into a little romance that maybe isn't yours for 5 minutes. So you can just dream away.
That's exactly it. Yeah. And I really do believe that the books, they're so enchanting with the storylines. And I think it does just give people, I mean, a little bit of respite from what's been going on.
Definitely. And obviously it's set in Hawaii. So, you know, even just being on the beach there and just, I was reading it just thinking, oh my gosh, I really want to go on holiday. Like that's the first thing, isn't it? That everybody's just so excited about. But it does take you back to those moments. When you were writing it, were you looking through old pictures of being on holiday?
Oh yes, so much. I mean, the planning for this book has been a really long time. So I did actually manage to get away last summer. And then I was writing book three. But you have to draw on so many personal experiences. And I think I have projected a lot of, you know, kind of qualities that I love in people that are really close to me into all of the characters in the books. And maybe because there are four main girlies throughout all of the four books. And I think maybe I've made them into sort of people that I would really love to be one day. Wow. And even though they're all really different, they've got really special qualities. And I was really grateful that I was able to do and tell all of the four girls' stories separately. Because sometimes I think, you know, my books are normally 80,000 words. You can't actually do every woman justice in a book in that much. No. So it's been really special that I've had the opportunity to really show off who they are. And also write in some really, really gorgeous men.
You can like make up the kind of like perfect guy that you want and then dream it into a book.
Yeah, maybe I'm leading kind of, I'm four timing four different men. So I made them all really special in different ways. And it's quite amazing how they all look so different. So I must have no type.
I know. I always think I've got a type. And then I'm like, nah, they didn't at all. Are they based on your friends, the girls?
Definitely. And we all, I mean, the girlies, similar to me, they all grew up in Devon. But yeah, there are definitely qualities. I haven't based any girl on one girlfriend of mine in particular. So the girls would probably start fighting and be like, why did she get the book and I didn't? But there are definitely qualities. And I think lots of qualities that I have as well, I've unintentionally put into the books. You can't, even though it is fiction and it's fantasy, you can't help yourself but absorb the world around you and put it into, you know, the book that you are writing. It's impossible not to do that.
Yeah. And it's like Sex and the City, isn't it? You know, when you had your like group of mates and everyone was like, well, you know, so-and-so Samantha, so-and-so. And then you think you're a really different one. Have any of your mates come to you and been like, is that me? And you're like, no, you're the other one.
Such a good question. There was a lot of that in Meet Me in London because, you know, it's set on the King's Road. She spends a lot of time in Notting Hill. My best friend lives in Notting Hill. So there was a bit of that. But then there were qualities like Victoria, my first heroine, she was really creative and could make things and make dresses and all of these things. Like, my best friend can't do that. Like, she's rubbish. So, you know, they do know that it's not fully the truth.
That's so sweet. Are you basing it as well? Is your next book, are you like, where have I not visited? Right, where do I need to go? I'm like, meet me in.
Yeah, I'm just going through. It's a checklist of all the places that I really want to go to. The next book is in Tahiti. So that is literally where I will be going when this lockdown is lifted.
This is brilliant. I like this idea. You can just tick off
right
the list.
Right away around the globe.
That's so cool. I love the idea of it. You also host your own book club as well. Has reading and writing always been a big part of your life?
Enormous. It's just been my one true love from when I was really, really young. And I love that we started this book club. My assistant had the idea. And I was like, we can't do a book club. You've got to, I thought it was all, you've got to sit around with a glass of wine, and a, you know, big packet of crisps and discuss, you know, Pride and Prejudice. She was like, I think we could mix it up a bit. And, you know, we've been doing it now for a year and a half and people absolutely love it. And fine, we're not in person, but thank God we started it pre-pandemics. People who do love books won't have been able to go to their book clubs. And I really try to be a bit ahead of the curve with books that we choose. And then I'll just mix it up and do a really traditional book. But I'm really glad that I started it. It's a lovely thing. And obviously it's great this month because we are doing Meet Me in Hawaii and everyone has to read Meet Me in Hawaii.
You get to choose your own book for your book club. That's perfect. Yeah. Like, guys, this week we're reading Kelsey. Oh, look.
He's arrived.
So sweet. Has he been popping up in a lot of interviews recently?
Oh my God. He's like his mother, just loves an interview, but he's got to get his face on camera, you know?
Does he like your book? Which one's his favourite?
Oh, he chewed Meet Me in London. Yeah, he absolutely loved that one. But thankfully we're out the puppy stage now, so he's not allowed to go near Meet Me in Hawaii.
So previously you were crowned Queen of the Jungle. Have you thought that you might do any other reality TV? Are there any on your list that you just think, oh, I'd love to have a go at that? Any skills, hidden skills that you've got?
Oh, zero. I love doing things that potentially I have a chance of winning. Now, strictly, Dancing on Ice, I have zero chance of winning. So maybe I'm just bowing out gracefully. I just love all the glory. It's like, I have to
struggling with cooking. Maybe if you went on like Celeb MasterChef or something.
There was talk of that. Yeah.
Again. Yeah, you can do that. Because then it might force you, put you in that situation where you're like, I've got to do this.
Yeah, potentially. I mean, I have actually signed up to do Pru Leets, or it's Leets cooking course, but it's online. But I've been too busy, I haven't started. And it's like a class, so you do it as a class. So I'm obviously like absent every single week. But no, I think maybe MasterChef once I've refined my skills.
I don't think you want to get in Pru Leets bad books, do you? See me at the end of class.
I did the Bake Off, and she was horrified at what I created. So it's not a good start.
Maybe put yourself in as a different name so she doesn't know that it's you.
Yeah, good idea.
So you posted on Instagram that you are waiting for the 21st of June. Everybody is very excited about this day happening. I mean, fingers crossed that it is. I have two questions. Where are you going to go and who are you going with?
I am going to go to the most disgusting nightclub in the whole of London. And it hasn't had a refit in like 40 years. But it's my favourite nightclub in the whole world. And I'll probably have a couple of Jaeger bombs and a WKD. And then I will tootle on home with my girlfriends and have a dance party and have a stinking hangover the next day. I mean, there is no greater joy than being well up for that scenario. And I'm dying for it, but I've planned the outfit.
And that WhatsApp group the next morning.
What happened?
What happened? Everyone good? Panic in the morning.
Or you're throwing out the apologies. Either way, I'm here for it. And I don't mind either scenario.
Who knew that everyone would just be waiting for an absolutely stinking hangover? Can't wait to go out and get messy, have a hangover. Tell us again, when is your book out? When can we find it? What's it called?
So my book is called Meet Me in Hawaii. It's out on the 18th of March. And it is the most wonderful, enchanting story of love. And everyone should check it out.
And it looks gorgeous as well.
Oh, I know.
On your table, on your bookshelf, because it is such a beautiful cover. Love it.
So gorgeous. I'm so proud of it.
Yes, well done. It's an incredible book. Can't wait to read the rest of it as well. Thank you so much for coming on and chatting to us today. Thank you very much, Toff.
Thank you, darling.